Hi there! My name is Susanna, I'm a harpist and a harp teacher, and in this video I'll show you how I use my iPad and the ForScore app for reading music while playing the harp. I've decided to create a video on this topic because when I shared some of these tips on my Instagram stories, these short snippets turned out to be incredibly popular. If you're not following me on Instagram yet, you will find the link in the description of this video. And now, let's move on to exploring all the different options that iPad and ForScore offer to musicians. I absolutely love how clean my fingering markings are right now. And what's best is that I can make them a lot smaller and more precise compared to when I was just using pen and paper. And because they are smaller, there is now more space to add some extra markings, such as for example for the rhythm, which here you can see in green. And despite these extra markings, the score is still really clean and easy to read. Also, it's really easy to change things if I change my mind, or if I want to create two different versions with different fingerings for one student and another if they happen to have different preferences. So let's say that in this Scarlatti Sonata I'd like to change things a bit in bar 10. Let's say I would like to have fingers 2-1-2 instead of 3-1-2. So I go to the editing menu here, I'm picking the white pen, I'm getting rid of number 3, then choosing the blue line because I like using blue for my fingerings, and add 2. Now, if I want to share that with anyone, that's really easy. I go to the sharing screen, then pick annotated PDF, which is where all my markings are, and then I use an email client of my choice, which happens to be Gmail, and there it is, the PDF ready to send as an attachment. Another really easy thing is putting brackets in, and that's something I used to struggle a lot in the past as a perfectionist, because how do you draw them in a really straight and clear way without using a ruler every time? And if you want to change something, you need to use a pencil rubber, and there is always a bit of a trace, or you have to have a whole array of erasable pens, which I have never learned to use, but here you can just put them in using any color, making adjustments to the length and angle, and they are always perfectly straight. And if I happen not to like any of them, I can draw them again and again. So you will find the brackets under the shapes right here. In my case, they are again blue, like my fingerings, but you can choose any color you want. So if I'd like them to be purple, I can very easily draw some purple lines. So let's magnify again. And yeah, I can use as many small brackets as I want. I can very easily erase them using that rubber or just go back step by step. In the shape section, you will also find a stave. So if you want, for example, to make a note of alternative solutions next to the existing music, you just draw a stave and put your annotations there. So that's under the same section. Here at the bottom, you will find the stave. And let's go to those ornaments at the beginning. Let's say that I would like to explain to myself how to draw them. So the stave can be as big and as small as you want it, any length really. So let's make it sitting quite close to the ornaments. Then I can pick the black line and I can draw for myself those two notes that I would like to know that I need to play as quavers. There you go. Also, if I happen to scan a piece of music that already has a lot of markings, I can very easily cover them up. For someone who used to spend a lot of money on Tippex, that's such a great thing. So here is a piece I used to play a long, long time ago, and it has a lot of markings from my teacher and from myself. Some of them were in pen, some of them were in pencil, so not so easy to get rid of. But with ForScore, I can just go to any bar I choose. Let's say I would like to get rid of some of these lines and pedal markings, so I can magnify even further when I'm in the editing mode and very precisely erase whatever I don't like without interrupting what's already printed in there. So let me get rid of that circle first, and I can even go between the lines. There you go. Being able to erase existing markings is also a great option if you have to use enharmonic changes, which can happen with some pedal harp repertoire. For example, here in this bar at the top of the second page of Debussy's Arabesque, we can see we're required to use F double sharp note, which on the harp will mean using a G string. The most basic way of marking that change is putting a circle around the note to give you a heads up that you're about to play something else than the printed F. And here in that score you can see that this is already done for us. However, because on the harp we are so busy with lots of other things that a pianist, this piece is originally for the piano, that a pianist wouldn't bother, like pedal changes, placing fingers in advance, and so on. So I suggest that you erase this F note and you put in what you're actually playing, which is G natural, and that's super easy with ForScore. So let's start with erasing that F double sharp using white thin pen. And when we're in editing mode, we can magnify even further to get rid of the double sharp, of the circle of the note, but we will be very precise and leave the lines in place, because then we can use them to put back our G natural. And then you can use the stamps function, which I absolutely adore. You pick them from here, just next to shapes, and what I'll do, I'll go for a crotchet, because that can fit very easily under that existing beaming that we've got. When I tap on the crotchet, another magnifier opens up, so I can be really precise where I'm going to put it in, and there it is. What I absolutely love about the stamps is that you can use them with any color you like. And I think this is a great function if, for example, you're a beginner harpist and you're learning to read music while you learn to play the harp at the same time. Then one really useful thing that you can do is color all the C's in red and all the F's in blue in order to help you navigate your way around the music and the harp. This is also a great mental practice, working with a score like that away from the harp. To put your stamps in color, you go to the stamps and click on that circle at the top, and there you are free to choose any color you want for your stamps, from red for your C's to blue for your F's, or anything else you want for any other markings. And if you want to improve your sight reading, there's another cool way in which you can use ForScore. I noticed that some of my students have the tendency to stop just before a bar line and not look ahead what comes after, which takes them by surprise. And that's definitely not helping when you want to read music fluently. So what I sometimes do is erase all the bar lines from a sight reading exercise or a piece, because then you don't have that mental barrier and you just need to carry on. After we're gone through an exercise once, and then we're about to play for the second time, this time with the bar lines, the student gets to bring all the bar lines in using the pencil, which obviously is a really fun thing to do. Same as fingerings, I love how clear and precise you can make your pedal markings with ForScore. This is especially handy in case of scores which don't leave you a lot of space in between the lines to put your markings. But with the pencil and the ForScore, I can make my markings really small and precise and still read them very clearly, even if there is not enough space. ForScore is also really handy when you want to organize your music better. I love their system of tags, where you can add any number of tags to each piece and then also create sets of pieces or exercises. Sometimes I have a book which contains pieces from, let's say, grade 1 and 2, and then I hesitate where to put the physical copy on the shelf. But with ForScore I can add however many tags I want, so I can not only put this book under both grade 1 and 2, but also add an information on whether it's pedal or lever harp book, what kind of technical challenges come up in the pieces, and really whatever is important for you. In case of this Scarlatti sonata, I already have tags solo and teaching, but perhaps I would also want to have an information about the period where that piece comes from. So I'm going to type Baroque, and when I press enter, that tag will be saved. And now if I go to the library, I will find that tag under the list of tags, and when I click Baroque, I will find my sonata right there, along with any other pieces that I will mark using that tag. Another useful ForScore feature is cropping, which you can use to get rid of the extra margin in case of paper music and make the music appear larger on the screen. This can be done under the menu on the far right. When you choose the suitcase, you will find the cropping function right there, and usually the app does a pretty good job on its own, but if you want, for example, to get rid of the page number and make it a tad bigger, you can do it. And another thing that you can do is, if you happen to scan the music and it gets a bit crooked in the process, you can use the lines at the bottom to make sure that it's perfectly aligned, because that will matter later if you want to put the staves and you want to make sure that they are all really horizontal. So once you're happy, you can press crop and save the file, and now you can see that this music is in fact even a tiny bit larger compared to the printed version. So that's really nice. And since we were in the cropping menu, in the same section you will find the backup function, which is really, really useful. So what you want to do here is press on the plus, And then this can be a bit confusing because you see the options create backup and create archive, and you might think that backup is what you need. But actually, when you read that instruction, you will discover that archive is the function that allows you not only to store the information about the documents, but also the documents itself. So you want to click create archive because even though that creates a bigger file, you want to have all your information there. And then once the archive is ready, you just swipe left your chosen archive, and then you can share it with either a cloud or any other device of your choice, wherever you want to put your backup file. So there you have it, the brief overview of the functions that ForScore has on offer for Harpists. If you would like to know more about which iPad do I use, what screen size is best, how much memory do you need, and also which accessories are worth getting and which are not as necessary as they may seem at first, I've got another video on this topic coming, so make sure you subscribe to get notified of future episodes. I will see you here very soon. Take care in the meantime. Bye!